Yo, what is goody? How's everybody doing? My bad. I said I was going to do this at 6 o'clock, and it is 7:31. I got high and forgot. I've been in the studio. I'm working, you know. I wasn't just doing nothing. But yes, I totally forgot, so my bad. Sometimes I forget stuff, you know. That's what happens when you smoke weed and shit. But it's time for another lyric breakdown. Happy Webby Wednesday, first and foremost. Hopefully you guys are liking the new song. You know, it's not super complex. There's not as many, you know, weird references and lines to break down. It's more kind of right to the point, this new one, talking about a lot of the things that I've overcome and this and that. So if you haven't heard it yet, you're about to, and then you should go stream it because that's super dope too. But the song is I Can Feel It. Let's give it a listen.
You know they say it takes 10 years to become an overnight success.
True.
And guess what? We just passed 10 years.
So that right there alone, for anyone who didn't know, I officially hit the 10 years in the game this year in April. That would make it 10 years from when the first mixtape, the White Noise LP, came out. So it's pretty crazy. You know, some of you guys have been down for a long, long fucking time. So shout out to you guys because you guys are the only reason I'm still doing it 10 years later. And we're on a goddamn hot streak right now. And that's fucking incredible. But yeah, 10 years. A lot of people don't make it 10 years in the game. That is a long fucking time. I'm getting old. Jesus Christ, I'm 30. That's wild. That is fucking wild. But you know what? I'm still a youngster at heart. And that's all that matters, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get back into it.
Get it. Yeah. I got fans who say that I'm the only rapper that they listen to. Cause all you other rappers suck so bad that they be skipping. Not saying I agree, but it's a fact that I've been ripping. 95% of cats on every track I deliver you.
Facts. In my opinion, I am ripping 95% of the game. And there's a lot of rappers, first and foremost. So that 100% is made out of a ton of fucking rappers. And there are some really good fucking rappers out there. So I don't want to make it sound, you know, it starts with, I got fans who say that I'm the only rapper that they listen to. Because all you other rappers suck so bad that they be skipping you. Not saying I agree, but it's a fact that I've been ripping through 95% of the game on every track I deliver you. So, you know, I get it. I'm not saying I'm the greatest of all time, you know, but I am saying that I'm nice. And a lot of motherfuckers are not fucking with me when it comes to making music. But I have had a lot of people say I'm literally the only rapper that they listen to. Like, they're big metalheads. They like totally different kind of music. So they're not even hip-hop people whatsoever. Yet, for some reason, they find a connection to my music, which I think is super fucking cool, man. That's great. And, you know, let's get back into it.
I'm fucking independent business mogul. Shit, it'll take a decade to do what I did in total. Living mobile, touring all over the fucking map. And shit, now I caught a wave and I'm never giving it back. That's a fact.
I have been touring all over the fucking map. I've had over 50 fucking shows already this year. We did all of Canada. We went through the fucking mountains. We did the whole West Coast, and we just finished the whole fucking East Coast. Shout out to everybody who's come out to a show this year. That's a lot of you motherfuckers. And holy shit, I am exhausted. I just sat in the sauna today for like a good 20 minutes just trying to sweat out the Jameson and whatever's left in me, because tour definitely takes a toll on my health. But, you know, it's a good time. We're having a great time. The shows are all crazy. You guys leave satisfied customers, which means I did my job correctly. And, you know, that's all that fucking matters. So, I've been touring a lot, though. I need a fucking chill, honestly. But I'm going to Europe at the end of this month. Europe, super hyped to see you.
I invested in myself with just a dollar to my name. I've been up and I've been down, but still the energy the same. This shit, no amount of money that I get don't make me change. I flame up at my spirit that be never going out. Did this shit all for respect, it was never about the clout. It was never about the fame, honestly, you all can keep that. While I'm getting money with my motherfucking seat back, bring the beat back.
So, I just talked a lot of shit there, but, you know, at the end of the day, I think it is impressive, and I do get a little fucking pat myself on the back moment there for taking it from, you know, literally investing the last of my money, you know, everything I fucking had into this, and to now be, you know, at the most financially stable and prosperous point that I've ever been in my entire life. And again, that's because of fucking you guys. I'm completely independent. So without you guys listening, the money stops. Like, simple as that. You guys keep me in the game, and I fucking love you guys for it. And, you know, now I live better. I don't live in my fucking parents' attic anymore. So thank you guys, like, a whole lot. Let's get into the hook. It's been a long road with a lot of long nights. Been working my whole life. I can feel it. Listen, if you got a dream, grab that shit and hold tight. And you're goddamn right. I'ma kill it. If you wanna see a show, then you can get it on site. Alright, alright. I can feel it. Yeah. I said I can motherfucking feel it. Yeah. This all without a cosign, self-made baby. If those who came before me don't wanna fucking embrace me, they best get out my way or grab a mic and fucking face me. I'm hungry as they used to be, plus I'm younger and crazy. I respect the OGs, but if need be, I'll go with those who came before me, take their crimes and proceed. Now basically that entire section right there, I show nothing but love to the OGs. They paved the way for me. They are the reason I rap. They taught me how to rap, you know, just by them making the music that they made that influenced my life so deeply. But, you know, I'm at the point where I'm not, like, new either. So, you know, all I ask is just for respect and, you know, just don't get in the way of what I'm doing, because I am very confident in my skill set at the end of the day. There's very few things that I'm good at, but I would say rapping is definitely at the top of that list. So I'm also acknowledging, as much as I respect the OGs for everything. You know, I have a song like 2001. I'm literally talking about all the people that I grew up listening to and how much, you know, those are like my saints. You know, some people have religion. I have hip hop, and it's like all the luminaries of the genre as the people that I've based my life around. But at the same time, I'm going to get where I'm getting. So anyone who gets in my way, you know, could end up a lyrical casualty is all I'm saying. So anyways. Nothing but a Game of Thrones, and I've been building my army for a decade, and now we about to take it home, build Rome in the day. I don't care about what nobody say, till my fucking tombstone's getting made. It'll say I'm a savage, wanted it and I grabbed it, took it to the self-checkout and double bagged it. So I want to just make an observation right there. When I say took it to the self-checkout and double bagged it, I definitely use paper bags because fuck plastic, and I also definitely recycled those paper bags afterwards. So don't get it twisted, all right? The environment, very important stuff right there. Very important. Urban legend, I murder session with murder weapons, flipping people off while I'm swerving in the reverse direction. I turned aggression to lyrics up on a page, channeled all of my rage. Now fuck it, I'm getting paid. Now they say, I can feel it. Yeah, it's been a long road with a lot of long nights. Been working my whole life, I can feel it. Listen, if you got a dream, grab that shit and hold tight. And you goddamn right, I'm gonna kill it. See a show, then you can get it on site. Alright, alright. Feel it. Yeah. Said I can motherfucking feel it. So that is the new joint. That is I Can Feel It. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Europe, I'm coming for the first time in my whole life, end of this month. We're going to a bunch of places. The flyer's out. I'll repost it soon, you know, in case you miss something and you don't feel like scrolling back a little bit. Also, all the dates are on my website, chriswebby.com/tour. But I am so fucking excited to go to Europe for the first time in my life. You have no fucking idea. Like, I have never been, not even for leisure. I've never been on a vacation to Europe. I have never gotten to see that part of the world whatsoever. So I am ecstatic. I literally can't fucking wait. So Europe, get ready. I'm going to go fuck your stages up for a little bit. And then I'm going to be back in the studio just like I am this week, next week, and until I fucking leave. Because y'all needs a lot more new music. And trust me, it's going to keep coming at a very rapid rate. I apologize for the 4 weeks off when I was on tour. That's very unlike me. But, you know, shit, tour is crazy, man. Like I said, I've been fucking on the road so goddamn much lately. But I got you. Don't worry. The vault is looking fire. You're going to have a lot of new music soon. I'm about to go get back to work, actually. So I'm actually laying down a verse for my dude Apathy right now. And then we're working on some other new shit. So definitely keep your ear out and go spread that new shit. Go stream that shit. Go tell somebody else to stream it and tell that person to tell someone else to stream it and continue that cycle onward. Anyways, my name is Chris Webby, and it's always great. Happy Webby Wednesday. Peace.